I'm a Luigi, number one.
So my neck, dollars begin, hop off a jet, barely get rest. Cash through the mud and I get a check. You selling run on my pants and my chest. Chanel dress, clean up a mess. I eat a flesh, you know the rest. Count up a hun.
Hey guys, it's Lovestron, and this is my first video since the release of Smash Ultimate. And today, we're going to be reviewing Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Before I start this review, I'd like to say that I'm probably going to start making gameplay videos around Christmas time, because I have a capture card, but I don't know how to work it, so I just might as well get an Elgato for Christmas. Yeah. So, let's get on with the review. The Smash Ultimate lived to its name as being the ultimate Smash Bros. Game? Or does it fail at doing that? I think it's pretty obvious here that there's no complaints when it comes to the character roster. Every character from the previous Smash games is returning. And on top of that, there's newcomers. There's nothing else to say here. The roster is just simply phenomenal. The best roster out of all the Smash games, without a doubt. The multiplayer experience in this game is just as good as it would be in any other Smash game, with 8-player Smash returning from Smash 4, and lots of new modes like Smashdown, and there's also Squad Strike. And in Smashdown, you keep on fighting until each player has used all the characters. So say if I played as Luigi and my friend played as Ridley, you wouldn't be able to use those two fighters in the next match. And you can't use two fighters at once. So, you know, it's kind of like an elimination process, if you get what I'm saying. And in Squad Strike, you could do 3v3s and 5v5s. And, yeah, it's basically simple. So, you start out with, like, one character on each side. And then say if it was, like, Pikachu and Kirby or something. And then Pikachu eliminates Kirby, and say, like, King K. Rool's on the same team, it's, like, 4-5, because, yeah, I think you get what I'm saying. But there's two new multiplayer modes, and Special Smash returns, and all this other stuff returns, and you could also do 1v1s, and you could do 4-player Smash. The multiplayer is also phenomenal. It's the best multiplayer experience in Smash, because it improves every Smash game, and it just wouldn't make sense to say that the multiplayer in other Smash games is better.
It's not Melee, you faggot.
Would you get out of here?
It's not Melee!
Would you leave? Good God. Ugh, hate that guy. Anyways, the gameplay feels very good. It feels like it's in between Smash 4 and Smash Melee. And those are two very fast Smash games, but Smash Ultimate is fast, but it's not too fast that... It's not so fast that casuals will have a hard time. But people who play competitively will also enjoy it. So, you know, it pleases both sides. It pleases the casual side and the competitive side. There's nothing much else to say about the gameplay of Smash. It's solid overall. Like, it's not as fast as Melee's, but it's still pretty good. And also, it doesn't need to be as fast as Melee, because in Smash Ultimate, it's, in my opinion, I feel like the gameplay is better than it is in Melee. Single player is also very great. Classic mode returns, but instead of characters just fighting a bunch of random characters in Master Hand, they all have their own unique stories, and they all have different boss battles. Well, like, not, like, each individual character doesn't have, like, a different boss, but, like, they have different bosses, like Marx, Dracula, Rathalos, and Duon, just to name a few, and Giga Bowser. And, of course, Master Hand and Crazy Hand. But, yeah. And, you know, they all get their own unique stories, which is cool. And, 100 Man Smash returns, which is awesome. They got rid of All-Star Mode, but instead of, like, it's different. So it's basically 100 Man Smash, but it's you against the whole roster. If you get what I'm saying. Yeah. And, World of Light. At first, I was a little disappointed at it, but then, after a while, I started getting hooked at collecting all the spirits and beating all these people and collecting all the characters. There's not as many cutscenes as there were in Subspace Emissary, but that's just fine, because for me, I feel like World of Light, it's doing good. It exceeded expectations. Like, not by, like, too much, but, you know, they couldn't bring back Subspace Emissary. They couldn't make that many cutscenes, but from what I've heard, that there's six in total, but I'm not going to spoil any of them, considering I've only seen, like, two, including the opening cutscene, but I haven't completed World of Light yet, and I look forward to it. But for some people, World of Light might not be that interesting, collecting all the spirits and stuff, but for a lot of people, and for me, I feel like it's very fun and entertaining, and for the single player of this game, very solid, very good. This is the only part of the review that's a little iffy. So for online, most of the matches that I had, some of the matches, there's been no lag at all, and it's been terrific. But the other matches, the lag is awful. And sometimes it greatly affects the match. And sometimes if someone's in the lead, the lag can, you know, mess up the person that's winning, and it could completely screw over that person, and the completely different person can end up winning. But, you know, the past week, the matches have been either laggy or good, but earlier today I played, out of all of the online matches I played, none of them lagged at all, which is a good sign that online will improve and will get better. But from my personal opinion, I feel like that online will improve, Sakurai will make multiple patches fixing online, and it'll just get better, because why would Sakurai just leave it the way it is? That wouldn't be too smart. But online, it's good, but it needs improvement. But that's okay, because it's online. You know, Nintendo's not the best when it comes to online, but with a game like Smash, I feel like Nintendo is good when it comes to online, with Smash, at least. Maybe not other games, but Nintendo Online Service. Eesh. Anyways, the Global Smash Points, I like that system. I like it better than, For Glory and For Fun, but at the same time, it also sucks, because say if I have, like, 300,000 Global Smash Points, and then I lose one match, I go all the way back down to 150,000, which kind of sucks, but at the same time, I also like it, and I've been working so hard to get to Elite Smash, and I just haven't been able to do it yet, but I think I am good enough with Luigi to make it to Elite Smash eventually, but not yet, and maybe future videos, trying to get into Elite Smash, that could be a future video, so yeah, online's good. But it definitely needs improvement. There isn't improvement needed, but overall, pretty decent. Smash Ultimate truly lives up to its title as being the ultimate Smash game, with great single player, great multiplayer, and the biggest roster in Smash history, makes this, in my opinion, the greatest Smash game of all time. It may not... I feel like it could potentially, you know, be as competitive as Melee, which would be really hard to do, but it's possible. It's definitely possible with this game, with all the attention it's getting, and it's the fastest-selling Smash game so far, and it might beat Brawl as the best-selling Smash game, or as, like, you know, the Smash game with the most, you know, sold amount of copies, but it's currently the fastest-selling, I'm pretty sure. It's already sold over, like, 1 million copies in the U.S., and in Japan too, I think, but I'm not completely sure. But, you know, it's just personally my favorite Smash game ever, because it just improves on Smash 4, which is already a great game. But it just, it's so good. It's, and yes, it's better than Melee, fight me. which I love Melee, but it doesn't compare to Smash Ultimate, in my opinion. Maybe in a competitive standpoint it does, but in every other standpoint, Smash Ultimate is superior to all the other Smash games, and I just love it. And Sakurai did an amazing job, and I will continue to make videos on Smash Ultimate, and I can't wait to start this new journey on my channel, starting the next video with all the, you know, I think that I'm pretty sure my next video will be gameplay, which might not be until a while, but I just can't wait to start the journey. And then for my final review of Smash Ultimate, I give it a 10 out of 10. And fight me. I don't give it a 9.5. I'm giving it a 10 out of 10. Even though the online might drag it down a little bit, but honestly, it's going to get fixed. So I am giving Smash Ultimate a 10 out of 10. So, if you guys like this video, here's what I want you guys to do. Please like this video, please leave a comment, and subscribe to Lovestron for more Smash Brothers content. Have a great day. Couple Rolex, shine like the sun, you truly blessed. Who's on me tape? Give me clip boy like a Uber Jets. Yes, it's on me, got my Gucci shirt wet. Put it in my bag, I'm getting used to the rest. I'm with this school where they teach you finesse. I hunt shoes for the drip, I invest. I'm the boss, man, I keep catching the desk. Go to cool fast when they end with an S.